Let's look at how to graph a polar equation. There are a few steps we need to consider before we graph any kind of polar equation. For now, let's look at the equation of a circle in polar form. In order to graph this equation, we need to find values to plot. We can start by finding the zeros of the equation. To find the zeros, set r equal to 0 and solve for theta. Divide both sides by 3 to get cosine theta equals 0. To find the values of theta that make the cosine of theta equal 0, apply the inverse cosine function to both sides of the equation. This isolates theta so that you can solve. The inverse cosine of 0 is always some odd multiple of pi over 2, so theta equals pi times n minus pi over 2, where n is any odd integer. Now let's substitute one of the values of theta into our original equation. We'll use pi over 2. The cosine of pi over 2 is 0, so we have r equals 3 times 0, which is 0. So the zeros of the equation are the points 0, comma, plus or minus pi times n, minus pi over 2. Since all of these points coincide for any value of n, we only need to plot one of them on the graph. Next, we'll have to find the maximum value that r can have. To do this, we'll need to consider the behavior of the trigonometric functions. In this case, the maximum value of cosine theta is one which occurs when theta equals 0. So we'll substitute 0 for theta and solve. This gives us r equals 3 times 1, which equals 3. This means the point 0, 3 is the maximum value of r. Now that we've found the zeros and the maximum value, we can plot the equation on a polar grid. First, we'll want to create a table of values. Let's use values from 0 to pi in increments of pi over 4. We already know that the value of r when theta equals 0 is 3, so we'll write that in the top row. Next, we'll look at the value of r when theta equals pi over 4. When theta equals pi over 4, the cosine of theta is equal to the square root of 2 over 2. However, our equation is 3 times the cosine of theta. So we want 3 times the square root of 2, all over 2. As a decimal, this is equal to approximately 2.12. So we'll fill this into the second row. Our next value of theta is pi over 2. Previously, we found that r equals 0 when theta equals pi over 2. So we'll fill this into the third row. Now we have theta equals 3 pi over 4. 3 times the cosine of 3 pi over 4 is negative 3 times the square root of 2 all over 2, which equals negative 2.12. So we would think our point would be somewhere out here on the line 3 pi over 4. However, since the value is negative, this means we need to be on the opposite side of the pole from this point. Now we'll evaluate r when theta equals pi. The cosine at pi equals negative 1, meaning that 3 times the cosine of pi will give us negative 3. However, like we said previously, since the value of r is negative, that means we need to plot the point on the opposite side of the pole on the polar axis. Notice that we already have a point there. This set of points will continue to repeat, meaning we have the graph of a circle.